It'll just be a general overshot of the crowd, so there won't be any close-ups apart from the stage party, so they'll have to look at my very poor face. So, we'll start the ceremony this afternoon. If you could please be upstanding for the national anthems, we'll sing one verse of God Save the Queen and one verse of the Flowers. Please be upstanding.
Distinguished guests, before we begin, there's some housekeeping which Stacia told me what it meant. As we're gathered outside an operational lifeboat station, you won't be surprised to learn that we may need to launch the lifeboat at any time, although I think it's unlikely seeing we've got a whole selection over there. Anyway, if this happens, could I please ask you to stay where you are in your seats? There's a thing here that says about we're outside today, and if you feel it's going to rain, we'll get you a poncho. But that was a different night. The nearest public toilets to here are behind the Harbour Master's office. Like, they're regular toilets, they're not just behind the Harbour Master's office. Which is over there. And finally, could I ask you to turn your mobile phones to silent? John Gourley's on call for Shona. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all here today to Girvan Lifeboat Station for the naming of and dedication of our new Shannon class lifeboat. It's this orange and blue thing over here now. As we're celebrating the naming of the lifeboat, this gives us a chance to say a warm thank you to the John and Elizabeth Allen Memorial Trust, who have so generously contributed towards the cost of this lifeboat, and along with all our local supporters. In a short time, I will hand over to Alan Reid. Alan is a representative of the John and Elizabeth Allen Memorial Trust, who will hand the lifeboat into the care of the RNLI, accepted by Roger Lockwood, who is chair of the Scottish Council. After which, it will be handed over to John Gourley, the lifeboat operations manager, on behalf of all the crew at the lifeboat station. That's if he's not away on call. The Reverend Richard Moffat will then lead the service of dedication and blessing of the lifeboat. I would encourage you to signal to the stewards If you don't have a copy of the programme, as the words for the two hymns are enclosed, although if you're anything to do with lifeboats, you won't need the words to the two hymns. After that, Alan will come back to the stage and name the lifeboat. Following that, John Gourley, along with the Girvan Primary School Choir, who are sitting over here, very well behaved, will sing Home from the Sea. Bob will then give a vote of thanks, and at that point the lifeboat will leave the harbour to return, followed by hopefully Troon and Port Patrick lifeboats and Barra lifeboat. I have to tell you that Barra lifeboat was here for a refit. They didn't come all the way just to see you. I was on the first voyage of the previous lifeboat. Three of us went down to Poole and went across to the Isle of Wight to pick the Mersey class lifeboat up from the boatyard. And we got on board this Mersey class lifeboat, and to be fair, we had never seen anything like it. It was packed full of the most up-to-date technology available at the time. Last week I was also privileged to be aboard the Mersey when she went away for the final time. And to be fair, compared to sitting in this marvellous vessel, the Mersey suddenly looked like a Morris 1000 compared to this BMW that sits beside us today. It just shows how 25 years changes things in technology. You have to realise that I was still the fresh-faced youth that you see before you. I think that's enough from me. I would just like to say that the crew, since this boat arrived, the crew have put in a hell of a work in training, getting up to speed, and I'd just like to say I appreciate it. The other one that I would like to say that I appreciate very, very much is the real power behind any lifeboat station. And that's the wives, families and girlfriends of the crew. But these guys like to go out when their pagers go. They don't mind that their dinner's still in the oven. They think their wife won't drink their whiskey when they get home. Speaking from personal experience. But I would just like to let the girls know that they are most appreciated. Thank you very much.
Get me again, John. Didn't quite finish what we were supposed to say there, so I was quite a little bit short. We'll now have Girvan Primary School Choir who are sitting here behind us here, and they're going to give us a version of Rod Stewart's Sailing.
Thank you.
Later on, I think accompanied by our own local operations manager, John Gourley. So that'll be quite interesting, I'm quite sure. John didn't get to his bed this morning to hours. Now, I don't know what he was doing, but I don't know whether he was down here setting up or whether he was singing and performing in the local pubs and clubs. Is he not catching fish?
No.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the main reason we're here is the fantastic boat you see on the water here with the crew round about her. Fantastic piece of equipment, one of the most state-of-the-art boats that the RLI have ever built. But we can only do that through the generosity of our donors and our supporters. And through this, we can build these fantastic craft that keeps our crews safe when they go to sea, and more importantly, to deliver that professional worldwide lifeboat service that we have here within the UK. And at this point, it is a great honour for me to invite Mr. Alan Reid, who's come along here this afternoon to represent Mr. Professor Allen and the Trust, whose generosity has enabled us to purchase this lifeboat here. Alan Reid.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, I'm delighted to be here to represent the John and Elizabeth Allen Memorial Trust for the naming and dedication of this Shannon-class lifeboat, which the Trust has so generously funded. Now that's the bit I was told to say. We've come over from Edinburgh today. Professor Allen, we probably regard you all as friends, so today we can refer to Professor Allen as Jim. There's a lot of us come through from Edinburgh to be here because we're very proud of what's happened with the Trust. And two people even got up at 4 o'clock this morning, Nigel and Michael Baird, who are sitting here. Just to be here came a long way. Now, first of all, Jim is very sorry he can't be here today to see the launch of this Shannon-class lifeboat in his sister's names. He would have loved to have seen today's events, but unfortunately, his health no longer permits that he can attend. I will, however, call him afterwards to let him know how the day went. I'm sure he'll be delighted, and my wife there is filming it, so all of you smile. Is my hair okay? I've known Jim now for many years, and I'm very proud to call him my friend and honoured to represent him today. Jim, to me and his friends, has many a life story to tell if you ever met him. One of the life lessons I've learned from him is never ever forget a kindness. That's where the journey for this boat here began. Now, Jim will be 80 in a couple of months, but as a child, so it was a few years ago now, Jim would be taken on family holidays to get some sea air, and always took an interest in the lifeboat stations wherever he went. The kind volunteers were always welcoming and showed him around, and he was fascinated by this all those years ago. And how brave the volunteers were putting their lives on the line for others. It was at this point all those years ago that he would never forget the kindness that those volunteers showed him on visits. They would take him round the boat, they would show him the engine. He even got to sat in one of the seats one day, which delighted a little boy. As part of his family, Jim had two sisters, Elizabeth and Gertrude, or as he affectionately refers to them as, Betty and Gertie. Both sisters had looked after Jim as a youngster, as his health wasn't great as a child either. And when Betty and Gertie themselves became unwell in 2011, Jim took them both into his own house to care for them, as they had for him when he was ill in his earlier life. Sadly, Betty passed away in 2013 and Gertie in 2014. Incidentally, as you'll see in your programme, it would have been Gertie's 91st birthday today. So again, the kindness that the sisters had shown him was never forgotten. And we stand here today with this new boat, celebrating the relationship he had with his sisters, and with a smile. Some of you may not know, but this is only one of four boats that the trust Jim set up is donating to the RNLI, and this is his way of never forgetting the kindness shown to him as a child. On a personal note, and not written down, one of the boats is getting named after my children. They're here today. And because he wants to thank me for some of the help I've given him. Maybe if all of us could remember the kindness shown to us, the world would be a better place today. If Jim were here, I know there's a few people he would like to thank. First of all, Nigel Baird. Nigel, for all your help over the years, as a friend first, but as a trustee of the trust itself. You've been there from the beginning, and he values you so much. Also, Nigel's brother, Michael, is here today. It's been great to meet them for the first time, spoken over the phone for many years. Michael calls Jim every morning to say hello, make sure he's up and out of his bed, and look after him. And for somebody who lives this by himself, that's a lovely thing to do. We also have to mention the amazing Jenny Rochel, who helped the Trust get to the point of allocating the boats in the first place. She's now left the RNLI to go on to other things, but Jim and I will always stay in touch with her and remain firm friends. A big thank you now to Joanne Stewart-Clark, sitting down here, of the RNLI, who took over from Jenny and is doing such a fabulous job. Thank you very much. Everything you do is appreciated very much. And the final message that was going to be passed on to all of you from Jim was that it took a long time for the Trust to get to a point where we could do something about a boat for the RNLI. But that wasn't the hard work. The hard work is put in by the crew. The hard work is put in by the duties that you do and risk your lives on a daily basis. And he wants to know that the important person here today, the people that are important to everybody, are all of the crew standing out there. But we've all to be careful of Jamie, I think he's troubled. And I did ask, there is one lady crew member who just couldn't be here today. So thank you to everyone. Thanks for welcoming.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, families, first of all, marvellous to see so many of you here this afternoon. The sun is no longer shining, but the wind is coming from the right direction, so all is relatively well and safe. I am Roger Lockwood. You might have seen that from the programme. I'm the chairman of the Scottish Council of the Arran and Eye. I took over this job just a few months ago from Sir Andrew Cuby, who many of you might know, who was in the role for 20, 30 years, a very long time, knew the Arran and Eye in Scotland like the back of his hand, knew everybody who took part in it. I'm very conscious that I've got an enormous pair of shoes to fill, and it's going to take me 20 to 30 years as well to get to his level of understanding. He was also, needless to say, a very good friend of Professor Allen, and so there's a link there too. Now, most of you again here will know that Girvan has had a lifeboat here for over 150 years. So just towards the end of the middle of the 19th century, there's been a lifeboat here in Girvan, doing the work that Alan mentioned earlier on. Things have moved on a bit since then. Today's crew here are the successors of those people who were rowed out in the rowing boat 150 years ago. They have the same sense of purpose, echoing really Alan's words, the courage, the selflessness, the amazing ability to get out there in all waters. There's a photograph in the office of this boat coming in on her delivery, vertical at one point. Astonishing photograph. I don't know if you were on board at the time, but it must have been a bit scary. But you can see she's here safely. Things have moved on. We have a rather better equipment these days than they had 150 years ago. And this lifeboat is the epitome of the modern lifeboat, probably the best in the world today. But of course, she can sit there doing absolutely nothing unless she's got the right people to man the crew, to have women the crew in one case. Their support, which is the station management, the fundraisers, of course, hugely important. Here we have a trust, but fundraisers generally, and the families, again, which has been mentioned by John. Without all of you, crew, management, fundraisers, families, none of this could happen. And so on behalf of the Arran and Eye, I'd like to say thank you very much to all of you for what you do. Every one of you, in your own different way, is a lifesaver. Thank you very much indeed for all that. I've been very kindly advised by my daughter that my badge is skew with. Is now, I hope, correct. Thank you, Jenny. Going back to the trust now, of course. We're here because of the generosity of the Trust, and we have to be extraordinarily grateful again to the Trust for what they've done. Alan mentioned that this is but the first of four boats the Trust is delivering to the Arran and Eye. That's two Shannon and two Atlantic 85 inshore lifeboats. It's a huge, huge gesture, huge, huge gift to the organisation. But this boat, the Elizabeth and Gertrude Allen, is the first of the Shannons we've delivered out of those four. It's only the second Shannon in Scotland, and it's the first Shannon on the west coast. So this boat here will be blazing a path on the west coast of Scotland until she's joined by another Shannon in due course. Leverborough, in fact, which just arrived, and she'll be named later on this year. But to the Trust, therefore, I have great honour. It's a great honour for me, great pride for me, to be able to accept this lifeboat from the Trust on behalf of the Arran and Eye, and now I have the great pleasure of handing the boat to John Gawley, the lifeboat operations manager, into his hands, into the safe, very safe hands and care of the crew here in Girvan. Thank you very much indeed, all of you over there. Thank you.
Why I'm even taking this speech out of my pocket, because I'm sure that Shona sold the speech to John Warwick. Thank you, Roger. Honoured and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm sure I speak for all of us at the Girvan Lifeboat Station when I say this is a very proud and happy day for our station, and indeed the whole community. We are extremely grateful to the John and Elizabeth Allen Memorial Trust for providing us with this Shannon-class lifeboat. As operations manager, it is my responsibility to authorise the launch of the lifeboat when requested by Her Majesty's Coast Guard, and to send a pager message to the crew asking them to get down to the lifeboat station as quickly and as safely as possible without breaking speed limit. I said earlier that this is a happy day for Girvan Lifeboat Station, and it is. But last Thursday, our Mersey, Lifeboat 1237, the Sylvia Burrell, left Girvan Harbour for the last time. She was crewed by her previous coxswain, Robert McMaster, who is now our area life-saving manager. Our new coxswain, Callum Govis, John Warwick, our chairman, Ian McClymont, my deputy launching authority. Well, these two guys are retired crew. I was going to see all crew in the new, but I would have been shot in the place. Also aboard were three trainees, Brogan McDowell, Jamie Hamilton, and Fraser Stirling. She was headed for Troon, where she was to be lifted from the water onto a low loader and head for RNLI headquarters at Poole in Dorset. There she would join the reserve fleet. Now, I suppose I could place a bet on this. But apart from the three youngsters, I bet you the rest of the crew all had a lump in their throat. And loads of memories flying round in their minds. Sylvia Burrell served the station well for 25 years. Now, I have this on authority from Poole and Perth. She launched 235 times on service. She landed 324 people ashore safely and saved 15 from drowning. As I say, Sylvia served the station well. Our new Shannon-class lifeboat is the first RNLI all-weather lifeboat to be fitted with water jets instead of propellers. This means that the boat can operate in shallow water without the worry of fouling propellers with rope, floating debris, seaweed, anything. She can be manoeuvred alongside a casualty vessel with ease and navigate safely around hazards. The hull is designed to minimise slamming in heavy seas, and it is the first lifeboat to incorporate complete shock-absorbing seats for the crew. Now, Shannon's speed is nearly double that of the Mersey, so she can reach a casualty vessel in nearly half the time. Because of her shallow draft, she is ideally suited for the tidal conditions here in Girvan Harbour. This Shannon-class lifeboat means that we now have the latest and finest rescue equipment available. And I know, and the crew know, that when she heads out to sea, we have the peace of mind that this lifeboat will keep those aboard safe. I would also like to add that this boat has arrived nearly 2 years early, so training time and commitment of the crew have endured before this boat could go in service has been extremely vigorous, spending many hours, days and 2 weeks at sea or in a classroom situation down in Poole. So at this point, I'd like to apologise to the wives, the partners and the girlfriends, and I'll thank you for your commitment. Honoured and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as lifeboat operations manager, on behalf of this fine lifeboat crew, I am delighted to accept lifeboat 1323, the Elizabeth and Gertrude Allen, into our care. Thank you. I will now call on the Reverend Richard Muffett to lead us in the service of dedication. Thank you.
This afternoon to meet in this part of the ceremony.
come together before God to give thanks for the provision of this lifeboat, Elizabeth and Gertrude Allen. We dedicate her to his service and seek his protection for the lifeboat and crews to operate in her during the service in the RNLI. I would invite you now to stand as we sing together the hymn, Eternal Father, Strong to Save. Take this opportunity also to read just a few short verses from Mark's Gospel. On that day when evening had come, he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd, they took with them in the boat just as he was, and other boats were with them. A great windstorm arose, and the waves were breaking into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. But he was in the stern asleep on the cushion. And they woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do not care that we are perishing." And he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. He said to them, "Why are you so afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great fear and said to one another, "Who then is this that even the wind and sea obey him?" We are grateful indeed that God is present with us, and that he's given to each of the crew trustworthiness, courage, selfless sacrifice and dependability. We're grateful for what they do. Let us unite our hearts in prayer and let us pray. Heavenly Father, we desire to express our grateful thanks for the provision of this lifeboat, the boathouse in which she will be housed, and for the generosity of the donors. We give thanks too for the skills and dedication of those involved in her design and building, and those who have the responsibility of maintaining her throughout her years of service. We pray especially for the protection of the crew who will serve in her, in whatever circumstances they may find themselves, that they may know your saving power. We give you thanks in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us when we prayed to say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Would you please stand as we now dedicate this lifeboat? Faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, we dedicate this lifeboat for the noble purpose of rescuing those in danger on the sea. We commend to his care all those who serve in her. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us again unite our hearts in prayer. Merciful Father, all things in heaven and earth are held within your loving care. Look with favour upon the Royal National Lifeboat Institution. Protect and bless the crews of all our lifeboats, our lifeguards, and all who risk their own safety to bring help to others. Guide all who work for the institution as volunteers, supporters, or staff, that they may be faithful to the vision of its founder, so they may always be seen as a beacon of hope and light to those who find themselves in peril on the seas. Through the same Jesus Christ, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honour and glory now and forever. Amen. Conclude this part of the ceremony by singing together, Will Your Anchor Hold? Pleasure, may God bless you. In care, anxiety, or trouble,
may God sustain you. In peril and in danger, may God protect you. In the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore.
Official naming of 1323, and at this point I would like to invite back to the stage Mr. Alan Reid to carry that duty.
I'm trying to memorise this, so I won't look at my business. I name this boat Elizabeth and Gertrude Allen. May God bless her and all that serve on her.
Thank you, Callum, for that gesture on the boat there. Brings a tear to my eye. and it was a malt, I believe it was, the 12-year-old Malvinian and not cold tea. We had that discussion about using cold tea, but we were over the road, so it has been gently malt whiskey. At this point, I think we have three cheers for the Elizabeth and Gertrude Allen. Hip hip! Accompanied by our own lifeboat operations manager here, Mr. John Gourley, who is going to lead the singing on what has become almost a lifeboat anthem, "In Hope from the Sea." The words are very pertinent to the cruise, and when you hear the words, it can bring a tear to an eye and a lump to a throat. And I'm sure John's singing voice will be fine for today. It was well lubricated last night, so I'm sure it's well oiled for today. And the compliment of the Girvan Choir will just enhance this. John Gourley and the Girvan Primary School Choir.
And the Girvan.
Souls we can save, and we'll pass.
town, on the street that runs down to the sea and the harbour wall. They were gathered in pairs at the foot of the stairs to wait for a radio call. Then just before dawn, when all hope was gone, came a hush and a faraway sound. 'Twas a coxswain, he roared, "Of survivors on board, thank God, and we're home, we're bound." And we're carrying them home.
To Alan, who's came here today to be Professor Alan, or Jim, as we've came to know him, as to be his representative here today. And it's always nice to have somebody who's close to the person, and it is occasionally unusual in a lifeboat when we are naming a lifeboat. A lot of the names of lifeboats are people who have sadly passed, but on this occasion, the donor is still well with us and very still active. And Alan, I would like to say thank you, firstly, for coming along here today and delivering the kind words representing Jim. And when you do go back to speak to him, do please pass on our very much our heartfelt thank you for the way that I'm alive, but more particularly, everybody here connected with Girvan Lifeboat, the crew, the families, the fundraisers. It's an absolutely fantastic gesture, and ensure, Professor Alan, that this boat here will be as shiny, as clean, as tidy, or it better be calm, so it will be maintained and looked after for many, many years. To the speakers, the podium party, the entertainers, whatever words we want to use for them, the Reverend Richard for coming along to deliver the blessing, John for his gracious words of from the station's point of view, and of course from his musical accompaniment. John Warwick, chairman, to come along and entertain us and give us a few laughs there, but to fulfill his role. Alan, we've already mentioned, we've heard enough about him today. Roger to come along, Roger's chair of the Scottish Council, to come along here to give his time representing the Arno Line, the wider Arno Line, it's always nice to have that representation. And of course, the Vice Lord Lieutenant John Dalrymple Hamilton coming along here today. And very much, he's very much the smartest person here. I thought he was going to get that. To the musical accompaniment, any ceremony is always enhanced with some music, and today it has been definitely done so. We have the Naskin Brass Band at the back there. Thank you very much, the Naskin Brass Band. As already mentioned, we have some of the dodgy jumpers at the back here, and that might just be the attire of some of them, but thank you very much, guys. The primary school. It's fantastic to have the kids involved in these. These are the future of the lifeboat here in Girvan. Many of them sitting here today see this fantastic boat. They get involved within the community. It's great to see you along here. And I'm sure we have future crew sitting in their chairs there, and it'll be great to see them coming through in years to come. Thank you very much. And there is one other musical accompaniment here, but he's kind of hiding away around the back of the boat there. Come forward, John, come on, there's a story to tell about you. There he comes, trekking up the side of the boat. We've got quite major. Well, quite Ranger, John Wilson. Now, many of you know John. He's a stalwart of the pipe band here in Girvan for many, many years. It's great to see John back amongst us here in Girvan. John piped the Breed in, which was the boat before the Mersey, then piped the Mersey in, and has now piped the Shannon in. So he must be quite unique and one of the few pipers. Is that right? Must be quite old, quite old. Can't say too much about John's age. So, he's the top. He's still going up. But John, no, it's, thank you for coming along. John is ex-crew. He did serve on the Breed, he did serve on the Mersey. He first got involved in Lifeboat about 1982-83. But it's great to see him keeping his connection here with Girvan and coming along. Thank you very much, John, for that fine piping. Try and keep it shorter as I can, but we've got a couple other thanks to the South Ayrshire Council. We have the councillors along here this afternoon, and Provost Mooney, thank you very much for coming along. The support we have from South Ayrshire is fantastic. They give us what we need round about the harbour here in Girvan. We work in close partnership with them, and I'm sure we can continue to work in close partnership with them going forward. And to Harbour Master Tom McKee, Tom was down here yesterday, one of the crew brought is one of the machines for clearing the path. And Tom is in his element, so you may get a request going through for one of them. Wherever he is. To the Coast Guard teams that have came along, and to the airport that have came to help us round about with the stewarding, handing out programmes, and just ensuring everybody's general safety. Thank you very much, guys, for coming along. But we do have, standing shyly to the side there, Rachel. She's now going to slink further into the wall as she can. Rachel is part of the events team, and she has been the main leader of the events team in Poole, working in conjunction with the station to bring today together. So these days don't just happen and meet people like Rachel to help us and keep us right, because they know what they're doing. So it's all exciting. Definitely need to give. It has been alluded to a lot in the speeches earlier on there. But the first thank is to you. Thanks for coming along, making this day special for the crew, for the boat, for the station in general. But not just for that, it's the day-to-day, the continued support that we get here in Girvan for the community. It's fantastic. Without that support, the RMLI couldn't be what it is. The fundraising that goes on, the events that get supported from you guys, the support in the community. From myself, I'm from Girvan, and I strongly, really, really thank you for that support that you give to the RMLI, to the events that we run, to the crew that we have. Thank you very much. And my last thanks is to the station personnel. Lifeboats don't just run, the station just doesn't run. It has a management team here, led by John Warwick. It has the operations team, led by John Gourley, and it has the crew. We also have the fundraisers, press officers, treasurers. We have a whole magnitude of other people that go on behind the scenes in the RMLI. And to them, I am grateful for their effort and commitment and time that they put in, and thank every single one of them for their continued support. And the last thanks goes to the most important people around about any lifeboat station, and that is the guys we see here on the boat, on the crew. These are the people who are there at 3 o'clock in the morning when the pagers go and you're rolled out a nice warm bed, and the next thing you know you're going to open the bar here at Girvan and you're getting a face full of salt water. It soon wakens you up, I can assure you. But it has been mentioned, these boats are fantastic pieces of kit, but they're very much a technology driven boat compared to what has been here in the past. And the training and the effort and the commitment has been fantastic off these guys. I think when you actually see it, and you stand back from it, and you see what these guys do, superb, absolutely superb. Thank you, every single one of you. You have worked tremendously hard. You made me proud. As your area life-saving manager, going elsewhere, I can talk highly about Girvan, about the commitment, the dedication, the effort, and now the professionalism and the competencies you have on that boat. He's delivered a fantastic service. Thank you very much, guys. new boat, we have a nice shiny new coxswain standing there right at the very front. Everybody away. Callum only just completed his pass out in time for today's ceremony on Monday there. But Callum has came about the harbour for many years. I don't know, he started when he was probably about two, floating around about the harbour, pestering everybody in the lifeboat station to join, more so Dave Butcher. He was, again, very friendly with Dave. And through that, Callum eventually joined the lifeboat. 17 is the minimum age, and he came the door at 17. 8 years later, after all the effort, training, and it's fantastic to see Callum standing here now as a coxswain. Well done. Woo! You've heard enough from me, I'm pretty sure. The tickets, anybody that has a ticket, there will be a sandwich buffet, tea, coffees, orange juice, and some alcoholic refreshments that's been provided by the crew and some other people from the station. So we do have small glasses of wine across there. Everyone with a ticket is more than welcome to come across the town hall just across from the lifeboat station. Please take care when crossing the road. I don't want to write an accident report up today. All days, so we don't. So I think we do have some police officers about, and Alec Phillips is up there with his white chin and hat on. You've kept him safe. He looks like a lollipop man. He's getting to that sort of age. The Girvan Lifeboat will now actually leave the harbour under a guard of honour. You will see boats start to move about the harbour. Down the river here, we have flank stations have came along to show their support. We have Troon Lifeboat, which is just sitting in there just now. Port Patrick is just up here somewhere as well. They'll just be turning the sail round. And the Shannon will be escorted out the harbour with a guard of honour of both Troon and Port Patrick lifeboats. We'll do a little turn in the bay, come back in, and we'll go back into the river, and Barra will join us at that point. So the four lifeboats will be there. Fantastic picture opportunities for you. Bringing all our ALB lifeboats together into one place. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming this afternoon. Enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you.
Gracias.